أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. تنزيل العزيز الرحيم. لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون. لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون. وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون. وسواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب فبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم. إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون. إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم. قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون. أأتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغني عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون. إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين. إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون. قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. بما غفر لي ربي وجعلني من المكرمين. وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينذرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم قل يحييها الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون صدق الله العظيم
اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله يا الله يا الله. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله.
اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله 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 العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل 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 فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير، اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم، يا حليم يا عليم، أنت ربي وعلمك حسبي، فنعم الرب ربي ونعم الحسب حسبي، تنصر من تشاء وأنت العزيز الرحيم. نسألك العصمة في الحركات والسكنات والكلمات والإرادات والخطرات، من الشكوك والظنون والأوهام الساترة للقلوب عن مطالعة الغيوب. فقد ابتلي المؤمنون وزلزلوا زلزالا شديدا، وإذ يقول المنافقون والذين في قلوبهم مرض ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. فثبتنا وانصرنا وسخر لنا هذا البحر كما سخرت البحر لموسى، وسخرت النار لإبراهيم، وسخرت الجبال والحديد لداود، وسخرت الريح والشياطين والجن لسليمان. وسخر لنا كل بحر هو لك في الأرض والسماء والملك والملكوت، وبحر الدنيا وبحر الآخرة. وسخر لنا كل شيء، يا من بيده ملكوت كل شيء، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد. انصرنا فإنك خير الناصرين، وافتح لنا فإنك خير الفاتحين، واغفر لنا فإنك خير الغافرين، وارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين، وارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين، واهدنا ونجنا من القوم الظالمين، وهب لنا ريحا طيبة كما هي في علمك، وانشرها علينا من خزائن رحمتك، واحملنا بها حمل الكرامة مع السلامة والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا مع الراحة لقلوبنا وأبداننا، والسلامة والعافية في دنيانا ودينينا، وكن لنا صاحبا في سفرنا، وخليفة في أهلنا، واطمس على وجوه أعدائنا، وامسخهم على مكانتهم فلا يستطيعون المضي ولا المجيء إلينا. ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون. ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مكمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما طاسين حاميم عين سين قاف مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان حاميم 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 هم الأمر وجاء النصر فعلينا لا ينصرون حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير بسم الله بابنا تبارك حيطاننا ياسين سقفنا كاف ها يا عين صاد كفايتنا حاميم عين سين قاف حمايتنا فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم ستر العرش مسبول علينا وعين الله ناظرة إلينا بحول الله لا يقدر علينا والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز يا لطيف 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 يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ألطف بنا لطفا يليق بكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا من جعلت الصلاة على النبي من القربات نتقرب إليك بكل صلاة سليت عليه من أول النشأة إلى ما لا نهاية من الكمالات بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك
اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك
إن شاء الله we'll continue with ذكر الجامعة لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ. Inshallah, we'll make dua now. اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم، غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our Shaykh, teacher, Murshid, and Master Sayyidina Shaykh Faisal Hamid Abdul Razak. O Allah, may you increase him in knowledge and wisdom. O Allah, may you protect him from evil, and we pray that he will lead his murids on the straight path towards you. O Allah, we pray for the Shaykh and his family. We pray that you strengthen them in Iman, keep them in good health, and grant them long life in Islam. O Allah, we pray that you protect them from all evil, ease their trials, and grant them the sweetness of paradise. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Allah, forgive us for our sins and guide us on the straight path leading to paradise. O Allah, you know the needs of all of us present here. O Allah, answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our parents that you grant them your grace and mercy as they raised us in childhood. O Allah, grant our parents long life and good health in Islam. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive our parents and grant them paradise. O Allah, for our parents who have passed away and returned to you, O Allah, we beg you to forgive them. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the murids of Shaykh Faisal throughout the world. O Allah, we pray that you ease our trials and grant us the strength to face our trials. O Allah, make it easy for us to gain true knowledge and to practice it, to be good murids and to get ever closer to you. O Allah, you know the needs of all of the murids. O Allah, we beg you to answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the Muslims around the world. O Allah, we pray that you strengthen us in Iman. O Allah, we pray for unity and to make us stronger as a nation. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please comfort and relieve all Muslims who are suffering and have suffered losses. O Allah, you are the all-powerful and the almighty. O Allah, we beg you to give us victory against the unbelievers. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for the International Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa. May you make it easy for us to establish many masjids for your sake. May you bless the Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa to be a beacon of light for Islam throughout the world. And may you help us to finish building the new masjid soon and make it easy for us to do so. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadan wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursani walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
Allah Sayyidina Muhammadin abdika wa rasulika nabiy al-ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim tasliman bi qadri azamati dhatika fi kulli waqtin wa heen.
A'udhu billahi samil alim min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعذنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear murids, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this special program coming to you from the Islamic Forum of Canada, where we share with you this message of mercy from God Almighty to all of His creation. This is our daily broadcast. We start at 7 p.m. Toronto time or Eastern time every day. And we come to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum. We thank you for joining us today for our broadcast, and we hope you can join us every day for this program, 7 p.m. Toronto time. We kindly request you to reach out to others, to tell your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims that you know to watch the program. Share the YouTube link with them, youtube.com/Sheikh Faisal. And inshallah, they will look at the program, they will benefit, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do remember to subscribe to the channel. There's a subscribe button. You click on that button to subscribe. And then next to the subscribe button, there's a bell icon. Click on the bell icon and select all for notifications so that you'll be notified of all our different programs. We also kindly request you to enter your information in the chat, your name and city where you're from, and then your updates on the three projects, the Gratitude Project, the Salawat Project, and the Quran Project. You enter your update on the project, inshallah, the three projects. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. We want to recognize all the sponsors for the dinner program, all those families and especially sisters that have sponsored the dinner program. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. And we want to recognize as well all our donors, those who donated today and yesterday and before to the Islamic Forum, and we make special dua for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all our donors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer the dua and grant them special blessings and ni'mah and bounties and grace, our donors and their families and loved ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and increase them in His bounties, increase them in His risk, grant them more wealth, much more than what they donate to the Islamic Forum. So we make special dua for all our donors, and we thank them and we appreciate their financial support for the Islamic Forum. I also want to remind you what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in the hadith, ma naqasa malin bi sadaqa. Your wealth will never decrease because of spending it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma naqasa malin bi sadaqa. The sadaqa that you give will never cause your wealth to decrease. It will increase your wealth. And the scholars have said that your wealth doesn't decrease. It means indeed, certainly, surely your wealth will increase. This is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma naqasa malin bi sadaqa. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the hadith. And the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ayatul infaq, the ayah of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never attain true piety, birr, unless and until you spend what you love. You spend a portion of your wealth for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we invite you to donate regularly and generously to the Islamic Forum, and we make special dua for you. I also want to reassure you that your safety, your well-being, your health, as well as your spirituality, that's the concern of our program. This program focuses on taking care of your safety, your well-being, your afia, as well as your spirituality, that you can be in good health and you can be safe, and you can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from all sources of harm. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you that great blessing of spirituality, your connection with Him, your connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so every day we make this special dua for you, for your safety, your spirituality, and so on, that you can be granted the goodness of this world and the goodness of the hereafter. And that's the comprehensive dua for the believers that's mentioned in the Quran. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. This is a comprehensive dua. It's called a dua al-jami'a, the comprehensive dua, because it contains everything you can ask for to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's contained in this dua, the comprehensive dua. We also have a special series of beautiful short video clips prepared by our staff here at the Islamic Forum for your viewing, enjoyment, and benefit. Short video clips of interesting, relevant, beautiful topics that you can benefit from and you can share with others. As well as we have a special series of videos, video lectures on the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And all of that is a gift for you, free of charge. It's for anyone, inshallah. So if you would like to receive these special video clips and a special series of seerah lectures, then please send us your email address so we can send it to you, inshallah. Beautiful video clips and video lectures that our staff have prepared especially for you. I would like now to make a special dua for each and every one of you. Dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. All our donors without exception. And then a special dua for the sponsors of our dinner program. And then a special dua for all those who entered their information in the chat. And for each and every one of you, I want to make special dua for each and every one of you. Whatever dua you want to make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put that niyyah in your heart for that dua, and we'll make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on your niyyah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can accept your dua and grant you everything you ask for. And also, I want to include in my dua for my family and my parents, my mother and my father. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, and please do mention them and remember them in your dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. So kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب دعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in tawfiq and in qubul and in ziyada. Ameen, ameen. I also want to remind you of our ongoing projects, the action item we have ongoing for our program, the three projects, the gratitude project, the salawat project, and the Quran project. For you to engage in these projects regularly on a daily basis, and then you enter your update in the chat, inshallah. Today I want to say something about the Salawat project, to focus on the Salawat project, to talk something about the beautiful, amazing virtues of Salawat, on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to recite Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin abdika wa rasulika nabiyil ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Many are the great virtues of salawat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran the ayah of salawat in Surat al-Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 56, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim,
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. Yes, many are the great virtues and blessings and benefits of reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Among them, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned these in the hadith. When you send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. Look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. When you send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you 10 hasanat, 10 good deeds are recorded for you when you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 10 sayyiat, 10 bad deeds and sins are erased from your records. So you're forgiven, and then that bad deed is erased from your records, never to be heard of about in the dunya and in the akhirah, especially in the akhirah and the day of judgment. And when you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates you 10 degrees higher. You're raised up 10 degrees more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such indeed are the great benefits and blessings of salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In addition to that, your dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you precede your dua with salawat and you end your dua with salawat. So you sandwich your dua in between salawat, as we do in our dua all the time. So at the beginning, hamd and salawat, then make whatever dua you want to make, and then salawat and hamd at the end. In this manner, it's from the adab of dua. That your dua, and when you do it like this, your dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the dua of salawat, Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, you're saying, that dua of salawat is guaranteed acceptance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when it's placed before and after whatever dua you want to make, it raises up your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It elevates your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It takes up your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is accepted in that way. And then the salawat grants you nearness to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of judgment. He says in the hadith, "Awla an-nasi bi yawm al-qiyamati aktharuhum alayya salatan." The closest of people to me on the day of judgment, the nearest of people to me on the day of judgment, are those who are most frequent in reciting salawat upon me. This is the great blessing of reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, you get closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The hadith speaks of the day of judgment, but even in this dunya, you get closer to the Prophet ﷺ every time you recite salawat on the Prophet ﷺ. Closeness in the dunya, closeness in the akhirah. How close do you want to be to the Prophet ﷺ and to his noble Ahlul Bayt and to the Sahabas, the awliya? Yes, how close you want to be to the Prophet ﷺ? You answer that question and then you decide how much salawat you want to recite on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because every time you're reciting salawat, you're getting closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine yourself on the day of judgment, and there are billions of people there, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in the center on the beautiful carriage, the most beautiful carriage you'll ever see, tied to the burak. That's the carriage of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's holding Liwa ul Hamd, the banner of praise that is given on that day of judgment, making him demonstrating that he is the leader of everything and everyone on that day of judgment. as your Prophet, how close do you want to be to him? Wouldn't you like for you to be close to him? You can see him and he can see you. Are you close to him? You can see him. You can see the Ahlul Bayt on that carriage with him, the prophetic entourage, Sayyidah Fatima al-Zahra, Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada, Sayyidina Imam Hassan, Sayyidina Imam Hussein, and so on. Ahlul Bayt are there with the Prophet. Of course, we would love to be close to him. And every time you recite salawat, you're getting closer to the Prophet. So I want you to recite salawat as much as you can. As part of this salawat project, every day you recite your salawat on the Prophet ﷺ. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and honor you to be able to recite salawat on his most beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
La ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah. Muhammad Rasulullah ya Mawlana. La ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah. Muhammad Rasulullah ya Mawlana. Inna fil jannati nahram min laban. إن في الجنة نهرا من لبان لعلي وحسين وحسان لعلي وحسين وحسان لا إله إلا الله 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 Muhammad Rasulullah ya Mawlana Kullu man kana muhibban lahumu Kullu man kana muhibban lahumu Yadkhulu al-jannata min ghayri hazan يدخلوا الجنة من غير حزان لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا كل من سار على دربهم كل من سار على دربهم يدخل الجنة من غير حزان يدخل الجنة من غير حزان لا إله إلا الله 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 Muhammad Rasulullah ya Mawlana Hubbu ahli al-bayti fardun indana Hubbu ahli al-bayti fardun indana Wabihada al-hubbi la nakhsha al-mihan وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا لا إله إلا الله 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 Muhammad Rasulullah ya Mawlana.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. I want to share with you today this wonderful opportunity to gain much blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the hadith, مَا نَقَسَ مَالُ عَبْدٍ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ the wealth of a person will never decrease because of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that your wealth will increase when you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you engage in infaq fi sabilillah. Your wealth will increase. And so the opportunity for you to increase your wealth greatly by spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The opportunity I want to share with you is for our live stream broadcast. This broadcast that you have been watching, many of you every day, many of you several times a week. The daily broadcast we have at 7 p.m., the Jummah broadcast at 1 p.m. on Fridays, the special programs, the special maulids, halakas, and so on. So many different programs we have. And many people are benefiting from this program, as you know, many brothers and sisters like yourselves, families from many different countries are benefiting from the live stream broadcast. And we need to acquire new equipment and to update our equipment we have that we are using for the live stream broadcast. And there are several items we need. And the first one I want to share with you today and to appeal to you for this, it's the camera. We need to get a new camera, and the budget for the camera is $6,000. Our wonderful staff here at Islam Forum, they've done their research in this matter, and so we need to acquire that camera, and the cost is $6,000, and we hope you can donate towards this project. We've divided that amount into shares of $100, and so you can donate one share of $100, or five shares, which is $500, or 10 shares, which is $1,000, or more, whatever you can afford, and whatever blessings you would like to receive from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To make your donation, you can go to our website, Islam Forum website at islamicforumonline.com. And then on the donation page, you would see one of the buttons for the different categories of donation labeled live stream equipment. It's the second button in the list of categories for donation. So you click on that button, live stream equipment, and you would make your donations for this specific cause that we are appealing to you for. We hope you can respond generously immediately by donating as many shares as you can, each share being $100, and the total amount we would like to raise for the camera, it's $6,000. This is the first item we need, and there are several items. We would let you know once we collect the money for the camera, we would go on to the next item, and we let you know the details about that. So do respond, and respond generously, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Once again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ma naqasa malin min sadaqa." Ma naqasa malu abdin min sadaqa. The wealth of a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never decreases because they spend in the way of Allah. Their wealth will only increase. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them increase in their wealth. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your entire family and all your loved ones because of your financial support for the Islamic Forum. Ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين
اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you all with the greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. We welcome you to this continuing journey with the Quran, where we share reflections on different surahs and different verses and sections of the Quran. Today we start a special series on a special section of the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the qualities, the attributes of a select group of believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the title of Ibadur Rahman. And specifically, the section at the end or towards the end of Surah Al-Furqan in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions 13 amazing, beautiful qualities and attributes of Ibadur Rahman, the true servants, the true slaves and servants of the most merciful one, Ar-Rahman, God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll recite the verses and then give a summary, and inshallah in the rest of the lecture, future lectures, the details of these beautiful characteristics and attributes of Ibadur Rahman, the true servants and slaves of the most merciful one, Ar-Rahman, God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق
ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما ومن تاب وعمل صالحا فإنه يتوب إلى الله متابا والذين لا يشهدون الزور وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما والذين إذا ذكروا بآيات ربهم لم يخروا عليها صما وعميانا والذين يقولون ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما أولئك يجزون الغرفة بما صبروا ويلقون فيها تحية وسلاما خالدين فيها حسنت مستقرا ومقاما قل ما يعبأ بكم ربي لولا دعاؤكم فقد كذبتم فسوف يكون لزاما صدق الله العظيم.
This is the last section of Surah Al-Furqan in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions these 13 beautiful characteristics and attributes of a special group of believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls them Ibadur Rahman. Blessed is he who made the constellations in the skies and placed therein a lamp and a moon giving light. And it is he, Allah, who made the night and the day to follow each other for such as desire to be mindful or to show their gratitude to Allah. And the servants or slaves of Allah, the Most Gracious One, are those who walk on the earth in humility. And when the ignorant people address them, they say, peace, salam. And there are those who spend the night in adoration and praise of their Lord, prostrating and standing. Those who say, Our Lord, avert from us, save us from the wrath, the punishment of hellfire, for its punishment is indeed a grievous affliction, and evil indeed it is as an abode, a place, and as a place to rest therein. Evil indeed it is an abode to rest in. Those who say when they spend, those Ibadur Rahman, the true servants of the Most Merciful One, when they spend, they are neither extravagant nor miserly, but hold a just balance between those extremes. Those who invoke not with Allah any other God, nor slay such life, kill such life as Allah has made sacred except with just cause. And they do not commit zina. And anyone that does this will meet certain punishment. And the chastisement, the punishment on the Day of Judgment will be doubled for those who do this. And they will dwell therein in shame and disgrace. Unless they repent and they believe in Allah and they do righteous deeds, for Allah will change the evil actions of such people into good deeds. And Allah is oft forgiving and most merciful. And whoever repents to Allah and does good deed has truly turned to Allah in repentance. And there are those, Ibadur Rahman, there are those who witness no falsehood. And if they pass by futile, vain talk, they pass by it with honorable avoidance. There are those who, when they are admonished with the signs of their Lord, they are humble in response. And they don't behave like those who droop not down at them as if they were deaf or blind. The ones who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are those who pray, the special dua now of Ibadur Rahman. And they are those who pray, Rabbana hablana min azwajina wa dhurriyatina qurrata a'yunin waj'alna lilmuttaqina imama. There are those who make this dua, Our Lord, Ya Allah, grant unto us spouses and offspring who will be the comfort of our eyes and give us the grace to lead the righteous. And Ibadur Rahman, there are those who will be rewarded with the highest place in heaven because of their patient constancy in worshipping Allah, and therein in heaven shall they be met with salutations and peace, dwelling therein, and how beautiful an abode and a place of rest. Say to the believers, My Lord would not concern himself with you but for your call on him. But you have indeed rejected him, and soon will come the inevitable punishment. And Allah has revealed the truth. So here in this beautiful section of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about a special group of believers. And the context of the revelation as Babu Nuzul, it's important for us to understand, because it shows the way in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would sometimes respond to the unbelievers in different ways, and how also He honors His true believers, the true servants of the Most Merciful One, Ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people of Mecca, the unbelievers, the Quraysh of Mecca, their response to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the da'wah, the call, the invitation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were not only rejecting it, but at times they were cynical, sarcastic, skeptical, in this way, as in this insulting way. It's one thing to just say no, but to add to that words, insulting words, sarcastic words, it's even worse than that. And so when the Prophet ﷺ is calling them to believing in one Allah, and he tells them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most merciful indeed, that you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leave off the wrong things you were doing, the most serious and grievous of their actions is associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping other than Allah, obeying other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Idols that they would have at the Kaaba, and some they would carry with themselves, and so on. And so the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the Blessed Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he's calling them, inviting them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and telling them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman, this most merciful one. And they responded, the people of Mecca, some of them who were opposing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they say, "Wama Rahman? Who is this Rahman you're telling us about? This merciful one." In this way. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to this, but in this amazing way, beautiful way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to them, not by directly answering their question. He says, "Who is Ar-Rahman, this most merciful one? Who is Allah that you're telling us to believe in and worship?" And then human logic may dictate that the answer should be a description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tell him, who is Allah? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does that in other places in the Quran. In Surah Al-Ikhlas, for example, "Kul hu Allahu ahad." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Quraysh, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his description. He is one, he has no partners. He exists by and of himself. Doesn't depend on anyone, has no children, no parents, no children, no son, and so on. Here in this section of the Quran, the response is different and unique. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds by telling the Quraysh about those who already believe in him. Here you are, Quraysh, questioning, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Wama Rahman, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the same section, in the same surah Al-Furqan. They're asking, who is the Rahman? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, look at those who already believe in me. Look at those who believe in Ar-Rahman, the most merciful one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. This is how he responds. Because this is tangible proof, tangible evidence and proof of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided those who believe in him, what he has made of them. And so the people of the Arabian Peninsula who as yet did not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or believe in Islam or accepted the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they know the individuals who had accepted Islam. At the top of that group is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. Who is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? They knew him for 40 years. He lived with them. He was born in Mecca, grew up there. Came from a noble family. His grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, was the chief of Mecca. After the passing of his grandfather, his uncle Abu Talib, Sayyidina Abu Talib, the chief of Mecca. He grew up in that way. And they loved him. He had beautiful qualities. They gave him titles. As-Sadiq, Al-Amin, the truthful one, the trustworthy one. They trusted him so much that they would give their valuable belongings, give it to him to keep for safekeeping, almost like a safety deposit box, that you would put your valuables, money and jewelry and so on, in there for safekeeping. The Prophet ﷺ was the safety deposit box in Mecca. They trusted him so much. They honored him. They knew that he was honest and decent and upright. Yes. When the Kaaba was destroyed in a flood, and the Prophet ﷺ, approximately 25 years of age, he was the one who put the black stone back in its place in the Kaaba. And they were happy that he was the one who came into the masjid, the first person who came in, and they said that would be the person who would do it. And they were so happy when they saw it was him, because they honored him, loved him so much. So they knew who he was. After he received revelation, 40 years of age, things change when he's telling them, worship Allah, God Almighty, alone. Don't worship idols. Don't worship anything else, anyone else, any other being. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking them to think about this now. And then look at the people who have believed in him, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, an honorable person in Mecca. They knew him before he accepted Islam, how he was in that way. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, they knew him, how he was and what he was, his qualities. They respected him for his qualities. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, a great individual personality in Mecca, they looked up to him, they respected him because of his qualities, and so on. These great individuals in Mecca and later on in Medina who accepted Islam and believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding to them not in a direct way to tell them who Allah is, but by telling them about those who already believed in him, the servants of the Most Merciful One, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, what an amazing tangible evidence and proof for anyone to see. Because if these great personalities, these outstanding individuals can believe in Islam, believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, accept Islam, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what about you? That's the question that they must reflect upon. And a very effective way of conveying to people the message of Islam. And this is why it is so important that each one of you be beautiful ambassadors of Islam. That you practice Islam in this beautiful way, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you would touch the hearts of others. A beautiful ambassador of Islam. I give you the example of a sweet-smelling perfume. That if you're going out to a function, let's say a wedding, or Jum'ah, that's perhaps a better example, Jum'ah on Friday, because it's Sunnah to wear perfume. So you at home select beautiful smelling perfume because it's Jum'ah, you put that on, your body, your clothing. You leave your home and you come to the masjid for Jum'ah. You have this perfume on you, you're smelling beautiful. And then someone may smell your perfume and they may make a remark about it. Oh, you're smelling nice today. You cannot say that, listen, this is my perfume. I paid for it. It belongs to me. I don't want you to smell it. This is only for me. It's my property. Don't smell my perfume. You can't do that. Because that perfume is there, and anyone that comes close to you, they will smell that perfume, whether you like it or not. Such is the way that our iman should be, our Islam, that we live our Islam in such a beautiful way that anyone that comes in contact with us will be touched by the beauty of our Islam, the beauty of our practice of Islam. Ibadur Rahman, the special group of people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pointing out to them now, to the unbelievers, that look at my believers. Look at those who believe in me. You want to know about me? You're asking this question, Wama Rahman, who is this Rahman? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, who is this? Then look at those who believe in me. Look at their qualities, their attributes, the beauty of their character. Yes. An amazing way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to respond to the unbelievers. And so for us now, we need to inculcate these qualities. 13 specific qualities are mentioned here in this section in the Quran. Live these qualities so that you would touch the hearts of people through your beautiful practice of Islam. And then they would see how we are as Muslims, and they can be touched in a positive, beautiful way and love Islam and inshallah accept Islam. And for other Muslims, those who are already Muslims, when they see you practicing Islam, hopefully inshallah they can also be touched and influenced in a positive way that they want to become better Muslims. They want to follow your example. They want to be like you because you practice Islam in such a beautiful way. And beautiful Islam, practicing Islam in a beautiful way, does not mean compromising our religion. No. At all times, whatever we do, we must take our lead, take our guidance from the Quran, the Book of Allah, and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, the way of the Prophet ﷺ. Because sometimes people may misunderstand this expression when we talk about practicing our Islam in a beautiful way. And they may feel that, oh, we have to compromise our religion, don't do what our religion tells us to do so we can please other people. Be like them, do what they are doing. No, that is not Islam. And the beauty of Islam is in obedience. It's founded in obedience when we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But you do this in this beautiful way and you will touch people. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Hadith Qudsi, the Prophet alayhi wasallam says that, Inna Allah jameelun yuhibbul jamal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most beautiful one. And He loves beauty. He loves what is beautiful. So I want us to understand this concept as we strive to inculcate the qualities of Ibadur Rahman, the true servants of the most merciful one, Ar-Rahman, Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to mention in summary the 13 qualities, and then inshallah in future lectures of this special series of tafsir, we would deal with the qualities in more detail. But just so, as a way to introduce this section of the Quran and our reflections and tafsir on the section, so that you can start implementing these qualities in your life to beautify your Islam. Firstly, they walk on the earth in humility. This quality of humility, of being humble, how we should be as believers. Not to be weak. Being humble and to show humility doesn't mean to be weak. In fact, it is founded in strength of character. But it means don't be arrogant and proud. The opposite of that, be humble, walk on the earth in humility. Secondly, when ignorant people, jahilun, when the ignorant people address them, they say peace, salam, and they go away. In other words, don't stoop down to the level of the jahil, the ignorant people, to respond to them at their level. No, you take the higher ground. Your behavior is different. Say peace, you go away. Thirdly, spend their nights worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fourthly, they supplicate to Almighty Allah to save them, to protect them from the punishment of hellfire. It's amazing that they spend their nights worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, qiyaman wa qu'udan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another ayah mentions the physical disposition of his special servants, which is symbolic of them spending the night awake worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a portion of the night thereof, in tahajjud, in qiyam, in dhikr, in this way. And even though they're doing all of that, they still pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be saved from the punishment of hellfire. Fifthly, when they spend, they are neither extravagant or wasteful, nor are they miserly, but they strike a just balance in between. When they spend their wealth to satisfy their comforts, take care of their needs of the dunya and that of the family and so on, they're mindful, have a just balance. And also, specifically to when they engage in infaq in this way. The sixth point, they do not invoke any other god besides Allah or along with Allah. They don't commit shirk. Invoking or worshipping or obeying any other being, any other God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because people may invent these gods, different gods and idols that they want, and then they start worshipping them. But the true servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and obey only Allah, and submit only to Allah. And it goes beyond a physical worship. Sometimes people may engage in other acts of shirk that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has taught us about, which we would share some more details about. And they do not kill what Allah has forbidden. They do not take innocent lives in this way, except with just cause. If there is a reason for so doing, that's a reason that's valid and acceptable in the Islamic law, in the Sharia. And they do not commit zina. And they do not witness falsehood. And if they pass by vain talk, they pass by it with dignity. They don't join it, engage in it, in vain talk, backbiting, slandering, and so on. No, they pass by it with dignity, honorably, staying away from it. They are mindful of the reminder of their Lord. When they're reminded about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they're mindful about that. They're not heedless about it. Nor are they arrogant in rejecting it, and so on. And they pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a beautiful dua of Ibadur Rahman. They pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for righteous spouses and righteous offsprings, and for them to be leaders of the righteous people, leaders by serving the righteous people, taking care of them in this way. And they pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for patience, perseverance, and steadfastness in their lives. The 13 qualities or subheadings, because each point has many ramifications and implications as well. 13 subheadings we can pick, or subtopics, of the qualities and the characteristics of Ibadur Rahman that I want to share with you in this first part of our series of lectures on Quran, Journey with the Quran Reflections, specifically Ibadur Rahman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran in Surah Al-Furqan in the last section of that surah. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to know these qualities and attributes of Ibadur Rahman, and bless us, grant us the tawfiq to be able to implement them, these qualities, in our lives. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala record us and include us to be from among Ibadur Rahman in the dunya and in the akhirah, to be with them, the special group of believers from among the sahabas and the great believers of this ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us with them in the akhirah, and to be in Jannah with them. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها.
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها. صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها. صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها. محمد زينة الدنيا وبهجتها. محمد كاشف الأمة والظلام. محمد سيد الدنيا.
الملك وأهلها محمد شرف الباري مراتبه محمد خصه الرحمن بالنعم محمد صفوة الباري وخيرته محمد طاهر من سعير صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأهلها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأهلها محمد ضاحك للضيف مكرمه محمد جار محمد جاء بالآيات والحكم صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأهلها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأهلها محمد ظهرت فينا محمد هديه نورا لكل عام محمد عامنا إحسان نعمته محمد سر علم اللوح والقلم صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلما بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلما بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کے امین زندگی مل گئی
جشن آمد رسول الله الله بی بی آمین کے پول الله الله شادیان خوشی کے بجائے گئے شاد کے نغمے سب کو سنائے گئے شادیان خوشی کے بجائے گئے شاد کے نغمے سب کو سنائے گئے ہر طرف شور صلی علی
على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن لعلي وحسين وحسن لعلي وحسين وحسن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا كل من كان محبا لهم كل من كان محبا لهم يدخل الجنة من غير حزن يدخل الجنة من غير حزن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا كل من سار على دربهم كل من سار على دربهم يدخل الجنة من غير حزن يدخل الجنة من غير حزن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا حب أهل البيت فرض عندنا حب أهل البيت فرض عندنا وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا أكرم الخلق ما لمن ألوذ به سواك عند حلول الحديث العمام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم ولن يرضيك رسول الله جاهك بي إذا الكريم تجلى باسم منتقم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم فإن من جودك الدنيا ودارتها ومن علومك علم اللوح والقلم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا نفس لا تقنطي من زلة عزمت إن الكبائر في الغفران كاللمام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم لعل رحمة ربي هنا يقصبها تعتي على حسب العصيان في القسام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أما بعد My dear respected beloved brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum, and once again welcome to our special daily broadcast today in this beautiful Tuesday evening here in our Zawiya, the Islamic Forum of Canada. This program, as you know, starts at 7 p.m. every day, coming to you from your Zawiya, the Islamic Forum of Canada. We thank you for joining us today, and we hope you can be with us every day at 7 p.m. Toronto time. Do remember to reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know, and tell them about the program, encourage them to watch the program, remind them to watch the program. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program, and you would receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, with respect to the interaction with the program, please remember to click on the thumbs up or the like button for the program, and also the subscribe button to subscribe to the channel, inshallah. And then your information in the chat, you can enter your information in the chat, your name and the city where you're from, and then the update on the projects, the different projects, Quran project, Salawat project. Remember, we have started a new Salawat project for this year, 2022. So your numbers should reflect that in your daily report. And also the greetings. Today it's the first day of the new Islamic month, Jumada Thaniya, Tuesday, 4th of January, the 1st of Jumada Thaniya. And the Islamic calendar is attached to the email that we sent out today, so you can check your email for that attachment. Inshallah, you can print out the calendar, put it under the fridge in your kitchen, anywhere else, inshallah, that you can readily see the Islamic dates and the corresponding Gregorian dates, the English dates, inshallah. So enter that information in the chat. Any questions you have, put it in the chat. Any requests for dua and greetings and so on, you put that in the chat, inshallah. I'll go through the chat once we finish the other things, inshallah. And any questions, I'll answer those questions, inshallah. So welcome to all of you once again. We thank the sponsors of the dinner program now for this month of Jumada Athaniya. Tonight, Sidi Samir, Al-Faisal, Sidi Hussein Al-Faisal, we thank them for sponsoring the dinner program, and all the other brothers and sisters that are sponsoring the dinner program during this month of Jumada Thaniya. Alhamdulillah. There are some special events and things relating to the month of Jumada Thaniya, so we are posting that on our Facebook page. So do check the Facebook page, facebook.com/Sheikh Faisal, and you'll find it, the post relating to Jumada Athaniya, so you can be updated
you can know more about the Islamic month and the things you should be doing and so on, inshallah. So this is one of the important source of information, the Facebook page. So do remember to like the Facebook page and to check it once a day or so, just a few minutes, so you'll see the updates and the different posts that we have on the Facebook page, and also the other social media pages that are there. We keep updating them, inshallah, Instagram, Twitter, and so on. Then, of course, the YouTube channel, and another source of the lectures and so on, khutbas, and then, of course, the daily broadcast, the 7 p.m. broadcast, and then the all-night dhikr majlis, the all-day companion program, and the Friday Jum'a program, which starts at 1 p.m. So we have 24/7 broadcasts on our YouTube channel, so you can benefit from that, inshallah. We also today would like to thank our donors, all those who donated today, yesterday, and before. We thank all our donors, we make dua for all of them, inshallah. We want to recognize Sister Brenda Williams and family from Harlem, New York, for her donation to support the live stream broadcast. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Sister Brenda Williams and enrich her many, many more times for her regular and generous donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Ridwanul Chowdhury and family for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Tabassum Khan for her donation, the end of year appeal donation. Sidi Mahmoud Al Hassan for his donation to the Islamic Forum, alhamdulillah. Sister Halima Khan and family from Markham for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Mahreen Ahmed and family from Toronto, we thank them for their donation to the Islamic Forum. May Allah bless them and all our donors. Sister Shahara Farooq and family for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Siti Aisha Sharif and family from Chicago for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Faiza Arain and family for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Siti Wajma Wardak, Siti Rashid Walizada for their donation. Brother Abdul Ghaffar Sule from Scarborough, we thank them for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Nafiza Ali and family. Sidi Amir Shamsuddin and family from New York. We thank them for the donation to Islamic Forum. Dr. Tahir Chowdhury and family from Connecticut for the automated daily donation, alhamdulillah. And so we have the automated donation for the Islamic month. And so we were doing for Jumada al-Ula. And now the button has been updated on the website for the Jumada Athaniya automated donation, inshallah, for your benefit. Sister Alia Rafiq and family for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Sidi Sulaiman Ghaus and family for their donation to the Islamic Forum, alhamdulillah. Sidi Alia Khan and family from Ottawa for their donation to the Islamic Forum, alhamdulillah. Sidi Jamil Chowdhury, Sidi Yasmin Chowdhury for their donation. Sidi Sadia Chowdhury and their children, the entire family, we thank them for their donation. The end of year appeal, the full share of $1,000, and then also the monthly donation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them for doing so. Alhamdulillah. Sidi Neil Bacchus from Guyana, South America. We thank Sidi Neil Bacchus for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Alhamdulillah. Sister Farheen Khan and family for the monthly donation. Siti Hawa Vivian from Los Angeles, California, for their donation to Islamic Forum. Sister Marzana Tasmin and family for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Sarah Chohan and family from Toronto for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Brother Faz, Muhammad, Sister Holly, for their donation to the Islam Fund. We want to thank all of them and all our donors, inshallah, for their donation. We especially Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. And we'll go through the chat and respond to any questions and so on, inshallah. Welcome everyone. Thanks. Once again, do remember to sign into the chat, inshallah. We want to remind you of the special book we are promoting at this time of the year, the season, the Blessings of Salawat book that we encourage all of you to get, inshallah, and to get for copies for your loved ones, family, relatives, friends, your loved ones. You can give them as a gift, inshallah. And this is a wonderful book that you can study among yourselves with your family, recite it, discuss it. The importance of sending salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so you can practice it. And if you have those sessions, maybe once a week, for example, Sunday morning after breakfast with your family, you can spend half an hour and read a page or two, discuss the book, and then recite the salawat. Sit down together in a circle, recite the salawat. And it's good if you can do it in your home zawiya. Get in the habit of doing this in your homes, recite your salawat maybe 100 times, 200 times, 500 times, whatever you'd like to do, inshallah. The salawat from the Wirdul Aam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin abdika wa rasulika nabiyil ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. And it's on our website in the dhikr section. The Wirdul Aam dhikr is there, that you can get to recite this salawat, learn it and recite it, inshallah. So we want to encourage you also, as part of the salawat project, to gather together perhaps once a week with your family and loved ones and recite salawat. Read a page or two, three pages from the book, and spend maybe half an hour reciting salawat and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam 100 times or 200 times or 300 times or 500 times, whatever you like to do, but it brings great blessings to you and to your family. So, and then you can update us in the chat when you're doing so. I'm suggesting Sunday, because Sunday is usually a day that you're home, not working and so on, but whatever time is convenient for you. You can do that yourself, recite your salawat, and then get the family together, invite your loved ones over to recite salawat, inshallah, and study this book, Blessings of Salawat. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. And for Islamic School, registration is open for the new semester. You can send us an email for the registration to the admin staff for the Islamic School. We'll get back to you about that, inshallah. At the top of the chat today, see the Ilyas Ahmed and Siti Haseena Akhtar from Dimapur in India. Welcome to all of you, alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us, Siti Ilyas and Siti Haseena. And do remember to reach out to the other brothers and sisters and share the Wirdul Aam with them. Encourage them to recite the Wirdul Aam, inshallah. And if you can arrange also, or continue to arrange, a weekly gathering there in Dimapur, so you can gather together the murids and brothers and sisters to recite the Wirdul Aam with you, inshallah. Brother Keith MacDonald, Sisullah Brother Juan from Toronto, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Siti Shazia Maher and family from Slough in United Kingdom, welcome to all of you, alhamdulillah, and wishing Mubarak for the new Islamic month, Jumada Thaniya, alhamdulillah. And Siti Shazia Maher, do try to join the program every day, inshallah. 7 p.m. Toronto time. There's a 5-hour difference with Toronto time and BST, British Standard Time, inshallah. And then tell other sisters you know about the program, whether in Slough or other places, and encourage them to watch your program, inshallah. Sidi Shamir, Sidi Samir, Sidi Amir, Sidi Shabir, Sidi Shafir, Sidi Shazia, Sidi Sadiqa, Sidi Alima, all from Queens, New York, United States. Welcome to all of you from the United States, alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Ibrahim, Brother Muhammad Ibrahim and family from Pembroke Pines in Florida, United States. Welcome. Says grateful to Sheikh Faisal for the blessed daily programs, the Salawat and Quran project. Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless you more and more. And once again, reach out to other family, relatives, friends. Tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch your program and sign into the chat, inshallah. Siti Amirul Muhammad, Siti Azad, Muhammad and family from Pinal, Halak in Trinidad in West Indies. Welcome to all of you. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Sidi Haseeb, Sidi Yasin family from Brampton, welcome. Thanks for joining us, may Allah bless you. Sidi Maulana Tariq Al-Faisal, Sidi Kareen Al-Faisal from QREP in Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome, thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Farida, Babs and Umar from Pembroke Pines in Florida. Welcome, and Bab said, Jamada Thaniya Mubar, greetings to everyone. I'm grateful to Sheikh Faiz for the blessed lectures and du'as. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you more and more. Sister Razia Khan, Brother Tariq Firoz from Scarborough, welcome, thanks for joining us. Siti Halima Ali from Brampton, welcome. Siti Arifa Muhammad from New York, United States, welcome. Siti Zurida, Siti Zalia from Pinal in Trinidad in the West Indies, welcome. Siti Lazina Kharmular from Trinidad in the West Indies, welcome to you and your family. Sister Bibi Farida Chan, Brother Sama Chan from Miami, Florida. Alhamdulillah, says grateful for the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salawat Project, 200 salawat today for a total of 1,400 salawat for this year, 2022 so far. Alhamdulillah, very nice. Quran Project completed chapter 21. Alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Zaminur Razak and family from Cotton Tree Village, West Coast, Burbies in Guyana, South America, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Sister Brenda Williams from Harlem, New York, welcome. And wishing Jamaat Athaniya Mubarak greetings to everyone. Grateful for the Quran Project. It has given me an opportunity to understand what I'm reciting better. Salawat today, 1,200 for a total of 376,000. So, Sister Brenda Williams, the Salawat Project, we are restarting, we've restarted a new project for 2022. So, I'd mentioned that 375,000, that you a wrong number for 2021. And then you can start counting from zero for 2022. So today you do 1,200 for the new Salawat Project. So if you can maybe correct the numbers for the 4 days. So just 4 days of January, you'll record those numbers. What you did for 2021, you'll write that in your notebook, your total number, inshallah, and then give a new total for 2022, inshallah. Sidi Safraz Muhammad and family from California, Halleck and Trinidad and West Indies. Welcome, Sidi Safraz. Thanks for joining us. We hope you join us every night, inshallah. And keep reaching out to all the Murids and encourage them to watch the program, inshallah. Sidi Rahim, Sidi Rihanna, Sidi Bibi and family from Prisal, Halleck and Trinidad and West Indies. Welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless all of you. Thanks for joining us. Sister Mariam McGee, Brother Bilal, Brother Elijah Muhammad from Richmond, Virginia. Welcome, and thanks for joining us. We heard in the news that the weather is not very good in Richmond, Virginia. I hope you're safe, all of you, inshallah. Let us know. I understand there was a lot of accidents on the highway, maybe the I-95, and people stuck in the bad weather for several hours and so on. So I hope you're all safe, inshallah. And Sister Mariam wishing Jamaat Athaniya Mubarak greetings to Sheikh Faisal, the admin staff, the IFC family, alhamdulillah. So it's thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has brought us together again. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless all of you. We thank you for being with us. Alhamdulillah. Sister Halima Khan and family from Markham, welcome. Wishing Jamaat Athaniya Mubarak greetings to the entire IFC family. And Happy New Year greetings, best wishes for health, happiness and prosperity. Very nice, alhamdulillah. Thanks for your New Year greetings. Everyone can continue to do so in this first week of the New Year. Continue to extend your New Year greetings and best wishes to everyone, inshallah. Sister Shireen Jabbar and family from Scarborough, welcome Sister Shireen. Thanks for joining us, may Allah bless you. Siti Sabiha Qadir, Siti Kamran and Zara from Columbus, Ohio. Welcome, thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. May Allah bless all of you. Siti Hawa Vivian and Siti Uzair from Istanbul in Turkey. Welcome all of you from Turkey. Thanks for joining us, may Allah bless all of you. Special welcome to Siti Uzair, inshallah. And we thank Siti Hawa for your donations to the Islamic Forum. Sister Mariam says, Quran Project, today, Surah number 6, completed, and today 2,500 salawat for a total of 9,200 salawat, and Wirdul Am recited after Fajr Maghrib. Alhamdulillah, this is very nice. Try to do your Wirdul Am every day after Fajr, after Maghrib, inshallah, and try to memorize it, recite it, follow on the website so you can learn how to recite it properly, inshallah. May Allah bless you for doing so. Sidi Fazl Saifullah and family from Brampton, welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah, thanks for joining us. Sister Halima Khan, today's Salawat project, 7,000 Salawat for a total of 22,000 for the year 2022 so far. Quran recitation up to Surah 14, Alhamdulillah. Recited Wirdul Am and other dhikr. Also listened to Surah Al-Baqarah. Very nice. Very good, Alhamdulillah. You did quite a lot today. May Allah bless you more and more. And Sister Halima says, thank you, Sheikh Faisal, to the Murid's admin staff for this blessed daily live stream program and the opportunity to participate and being in the company of pious Sheikh, Sheikh Faisal, Alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you more and more, Sister Halima. Sister Abidan Shamail and family from Manchester, United Kingdom, welcome. Thanks for joining us, Alhamdulillah. And Sister Abdin Shamala did 5 juz of the Quran today and 25,000 salawat. Very good, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Very nice. Also, we welcome Sister Shazia Awan from Manchester, United Kingdom. Thanks for joining us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala And Sister Mariam has a question. Where did the Kaaba, the black stone at the Holy Kaaba, come from? And what does it represent? Alhamdulillah, nice question. Alhamdulillah. We have a full-length lecture on that. Inshallah, we'll do it. We'll repeat those lectures in the time of Hajj, the month of Dhul Hijjah, and so on. But I'll answer your question with respect to the black stone. So the Kaaba is the first house that was established on this earth for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before any other place of worship was established, the Kaaba was the first house or place established as a place of worship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Established by Prophet Adam, firstly, and then on the same foundation, Prophet Abraham and his son, Prophet Ismail, rebuilt it. In this way, and when the Kaaba was built, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a special stone from heaven that was brought to place in one corner of the Kaaba. And when it was first came down, it was white, pure and white, shining white. The angel Jibril alayhi salam brought the stone down for the Kaaba, put it in place, and it became darkened over the ages, over the centuries, because of the sins of people committing sin. And so it became known as a black stone. And it's there in the Kaaba today. And in one hadith, it represents, it's symbolic of the hand of Allah. And so we kiss the black stone, as a symbol of our worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this is a house that he established. Out of respect for the black stone, we kiss the black stone. Sayyidina Umar said he saw the Prophet ﷺ kissing it, out of respect, because this is a stone that came from heaven, especially to honor this first house of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we do tawaf, we circumambulate around the Kaaba to pay homage, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now it is very important that everyone understands that we do not worship the Kaaba because we go around the Kaaba. We, for example, come into this masjid and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we bow down on the ground, on the carpet, the new nice carpet, But it doesn't mean we're worshiping the place. We're worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is the form or the format of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has designed for us and taught us by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Kaaba is so special that we honor this Kaaba. It's the symbolic house of Allah to represent this place of honor. Not that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is living there. This is a symbolic spiritual reference. For example, the masjid is called the house of Allah, Baytullah. All the masjids throughout the world, they are called houses of Allah. Doesn't mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lived there. No, it's a place where it is dedicated for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's honored by calling the house of Allah. And the greatest of it is Baytullah al-Haram, Masjid al-Haram, Baytullah, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at Mecca, the Masjid, the Kaaba, in this way. So we honor this place, the Kaaba, because of what it represents, the first house of worship established on the face of this earth for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the black stone is there, a stone that came from the heavens, placed near to honor this first house of worship. And so it's a symbol to draw us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it has many virtues. When you go there to the Kaaba, your dua is accepted. It's a place where dua is accepted. And to be in the masjid, to pray there, when you perform your salah there, it is rewarded much more than any other place on the face of this earth. Every salah that you perform there in that holy mosque, Masjid al-Haram in Mecca, where the Kaaba is rewarded 100,000 times more than the prayer you perform here in our Zawiya, for example, or at home, anywhere else. It's such a great place that we go to. And then for the pilgrimage, the Hajj, or the lesser pilgrimage, the Umrah, we go there, we do the Tawaf around the Kaaba as part of the rituals that the Prophet established for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once again, we're not worshiping a place, we're not worshiping the black stone, the Kaaba and so on. No, it's a symbol that represents the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has great blessings and virtues, and we go there, we perform our acts of worship, they get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we're worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never worship other than Allah. Because some non-Muslims, they make that mistake. They see us Muslims doing circumambulation, tawaf around the Kaaba, and say we worship the Kaaba. No, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this belief is important, that we're not worshiping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the dua and dhikr and so on you're making, it's appealing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the story about, in brief, about the Kaaba and about the black stone that Sister Mariam asked. Inshallah, I hope that answers the question. You let me know in the chat. And thanks for asking questions, Sister Mariam. So everyone else also, you can benefit and everyone else can benefit, inshallah. Sister Halima Khan says, I was able to download the Salah timetable from the donation page on the website. So admin staff, we have the Salah timetable on the website, right? Inshallah. So everyone else, you can donate that. And we'll try to find ways to update it so that those in other cities can get your timetable as well. If you need it, please let us know whichever city you're from, so we can try to prepare that for you and put it on the website, inshallah. Siti Yasmin Chowdhury, Siti Jamil Chowdhury, and family, Siti Sadi and the children, all of you, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah, we thank you for your donation of the shares for the end of year appeal for 2021. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enrich you many more times. Siti Aliya Khan and family, from Ottawa, welcome. I'm wishing Jumada Thaniya, Mubarak greetings to the entire IFC family. Alhamdulillah, very nice. As Sister Mary says, grateful for the message tonight in the lecture, great lesson for us to implement in our lives. Grateful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mercy, and to have pious Sheikh like Sheikh Faisal in our lives. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you more and more. Siti Anisa Khan and family from Ottawa, welcome. Giving greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal and to the IFC family. My shukran, my salam to you, your family in Ottawa, inshallah. And do remember to reach out to other relatives in Toronto and elsewhere. Tell them about the program, encourage them to watch the program, inshallah. Sidi Ayan Khan, Sidi Mashur Khan, Sidi Rida Khan, Sidi Kawal Khan from Karachi, Pakistan. Welcome to all of you, inshallah. And Sidi Ayan says, Salawat Project, 2200 Salawat so far. So Sidi Ayan, you need to put two numbers, the daily amount of Salawat you recited today and then the cumulative total. So far, so two numbers, so 2,200 salawat, 2,200 salawat, and then today's how much, total how much you did today as well, inshallah. And once again for everyone, we started a new salawat project for this year, 2022, inshallah. Brother Ahsan Shabir family from Italy, welcome Brother Ahsan Shabir and your family, all the way from Italy. Thanks for joining us, make dua for you as requested, inshallah. Sidi Hasib, Sidi Asian family says, welcome once again, and says, grateful for the beautiful lecture tonight. May Allah count us among the few among Ibadur Rahman. So, Alhamdulillah, this is a beautiful part of the Quran that talks about a special group of believers, and in from Surah Al-Furqan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned 13 beautiful qualities of Ibadur Rahman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with all of these qualities and make all of you to be counted from Ibadur Rahman. It's a special group of believers that will be treated specially in a special way in this dunya and in the akhirah. 13 qualities, and inshallah we have a series of lectures, we deal with them in detail, inshallah. Siti Shazia, Awan and Sarah from Manchester, United Kingdom, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you. Sister Ruksana Begum and family from Brampton, welcome. Quran Project, the IFC Quran Project, up to Surat Yunus, and IFC Salawat Project, 2,500 Salawat today for a total of 12,700 Salawat. Very good, Alhamdulillah. Make dua for you and your family as requested. So once again, everyone do remember the new Salawat Project we've launched for 2022. So like Sister Ruksana Begum did 12,700 salawat for this year so far. And for last year, she did more than 500,000 salawat, inshallah. So record the number you did for last year as well, all of you, because we want you to strive to reach that number as soon as possible and surpass it, to do more for this year, 2022. Many of you have already said that the amount of salawat you did last year, 2021, was the most you've done in any year so far in your life. So inshallah, that's a great achievement. We want to build on that. Build on that so you can be better, you can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And several of the brothers and sisters, the murids in particular, they've had ziyar of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They've seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in their dreams. And 2 days ago, one of her sisters, Sister Maryam, she was blessed with ziyar of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She saw the Prophet in her dream. And when you recite this salawat more and more, you have this love in your heart for the Prophet ﷺ, this sincere feeling in your heart, you do it with that sincerity, inshallah, you'll be blessed with the ziyar of the Prophet ﷺ. It's a great blessing to have. Sister Tasneemuddin, welcome. Please remind us the city where you're from, inshallah. And you have a question, please, what can you recite for upcoming job interview? So what you should recite for the interview, you recite, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim. And you do that in cycles of 111 times. So you recite it 111 times and repeat it 111 times, as often as you're able to. from now until the job interview. Inshallah, it'll be easy for you. You let us know. But once again, do enter the city where you're from, so because the admin staff has that question in the chat for you. Sister Tasneemuddin. Alhamdulillah. So those are the brothers and sisters in the chat. We want to welcome all of them. Inshallah, all of you, and once again to remind all of you to enter your information in the chat every day, inshallah, to click on the like button. The subscribe button as well. And so Samari McGee updating us on the storm, the major snowstorm in Richmond, Virginia. She said people are now only getting home from the storm. So many, many hours there can be very difficult. We hope everyone is safe, inshallah. Make dua for them and for all of you. Yes, yes. We'll make dua now, inshallah, for the sponsors of our dinner program in this month of Jumada Thaniya, for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. Now, we had the end-of-year appeal for 2021, and we've started a new campaign now for the new year. The campaign for the new year appeal, that you can get the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this new year. So we have the button now on the website, the new year appeal, that you can go to the donation page and you'll see the new year appeal that you can do. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you in this new year and grant you many, many riches, and put barak in your wealth and answer all your dua, and grant you great things in this new year. This is our dua for each and every one of you. So especially for all our donors, everyone in the chat, inshallah, make dua for them. And for each and every one of you, whatever dua you'd like to make, put that knee in your heart and we make the dua on your behalf. So kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. A'udhu billahi samil alim minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به الأكد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة تشفينا وسلم عليه سلاما يداوينا وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وقوت الأرواح وغذائها وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأحوال والآفات وتقضي لنا بها جميع الحاجات وتطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات وترفعنا بها عندك أعلى الدرجات وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات في الحياة وبعد الممات وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين لا إله إلا الله الحليم الكريم
سبحان الله رب العرش العظيم والحمد لله رب العالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq and Kabul and Ziyada. We thank you for watching the program today. We hope you can be with us every day, 7 p.m. Toronto time. Do remember to reach out to others, your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know, and tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch the program. Remind them to watch the program. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, do remember to click on the thumbs up button, the like button for the program, the subscribe button to subscribe to the channel. Inshallah, it helps in the analytics, the YouTube analytics for our channel and the program, inshallah. So remember to do that every day as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you always in the shade of His special mercies. Until we meet again, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.